Mineral Resources Minister Mosebenzi Zwane is expected to visit the mine today. He joins us on the line. Minister, thank you very, very much for talking to us here on the program. Obviously, the news that all the miners have been rescued is good news, but the reality is that events like this are very unfortunate and shouldn't be happening, should they?
Good morning, Diane, and your viewers at home, and happy new year to everybody. I think you are right. Events of this nature must not happen. We can't have a situation where people are trapped underground for days. That is why we are on our way. We welcome the good news that everybody has been rescued, because this is people's lives. But we are going to meet with the management and understand exactly why were there no any other measures to ensure that when the power outage kicks in, there is a generator that can actually deal with that situation, rather than people staying underground for 2-3 days.
Minister, we had the opportunity, or our reporter had the opportunity, of speaking to a couple of the miners. What the information we were getting from the mine, or that was being fed to the media and to the rest of South Africa, doesn't seem to really be true. They were saying, the miners, that there was no communication. The first bit of communication they got was in the early hours of this morning, that they received no food, or if the food they did receive was certainly not enough for almost over 1,000 men trapped underground. The water that they received was very minimal. It was only received at the early hours of this morning. And there was no medicine, there was no light, there was no contingency plan whatsoever. The conditions were absolutely dismal. Now, to hear from the miners, very differing reports to what we got from the mine, I do hope that you bring this up with them.
Well, I've been talking to the unions. We are meeting today with the mining bosses to get exactly what has happened. I have different versions of stories, including what you are telling me. One of the aims of going there is to ensure that all the correct facts are gathered and we deal with the situation once and for all.
Minister, the issue of the mine going back to work and business as usual, again, that was something that our reporter highlighted. It looked like the trucks were going in and out as usual, and people were back to work. Surely, with an event such as this, it shouldn't be just business as usual. The mine should be held to account for not having the adequate equipment in place to rescue these miners and to be in a situation like this. So do you also think it should be business as usual or not?
You must remember that we still have people who have not been taken underground in a mine called Lily Mine. Situations like this, if left unchecked, our people's lives will always be in danger and they will not count for nothing. That is why we are going to engage with unions and the mine leaders and owners and understand exactly why would this situation be left unchecked, and if we need to take any action, we will not hesitate to do that.
Mm-hmm. So, Minister, your visit, when are you expected to arrive at the mine?
We will be at the mine around 12 o'clock today to ensure that what we have reported to is actually the truth and get the stories and ensure that if there's any action needed, we take an action today.
All right, we leave it there for this morning. Thanks very much for talking to us. That is our Mineral Resources Minister here on the program, Mosebenzi Zwane, talking to us about the situation at Sibanye Gold.